told me the secret to hitting this quad is letting the jump climb to the top and then think rotation. Here it is. No. Want to start having better landings. This will be triple lutz. Very solid. You can see the difference on that landing.
Elvis competing in his 40th international event. Over the course of his career, this is an important one too. So far he has 7 Grand Prix points. Trying to earn a trip to the Grand Prix final in Lyon, France.
Now 3.5 rotations. The triple axel, he'll follow it right up. No, he doesn't even get to the second jump. Things are not going well.
He was so good in his short program and so confident because now he is finally 100% healthy, as you mentioned.
But there seems to be a concentration problem here. He doesn't seem as focused as we have seen him in both practice and the short program. Remember, this program is 4.5 minutes long. It really becomes an endurance program the further into it you get. Look at that, though, getting it back. Triples left. That's the triple flip. Now the triple loop. Only a double. Fast feet on this footwork, showing that he has lots of energy. Boy, I tell you, Terry, we were so psyched up to see him really do great things in this competition, but it just didn't occur. It's like somebody letting the air out of the balloon.
Well, he talked about how excited he was to be here in Canada, now living in the Philadelphia area, but he said it also adds a lot of pressure under the microscope. Everyone wondering how you're going to perform. There's his mother, Irene, with a standing ovation. He said it is awfully tough to come home and skate.
He talks about how he has to get up into the air. No problem. Watch the spring. Plenty of amplitude on this jump. However, the arms don't come out soon enough to stop the rotation, and the leg doesn't go back for a good edge. More surprises for Stoiko. The triple axel always takes off forwards. Rotation, you would think fine, but no, concentration break.
And here is a look at the judges that will work this free skate for the men. What are they looking for, Peter?
Well, actually, they want to see a well-balanced program with jumps, spins, and choreography. Jump technique, getting up in the air straight with good landings on those jumps. Originality, quality in the spins, fast spins centered in one place on the ice.
Now the judges will decide the fate of Elvis Stoiko, along with his coach, Lucy Kistler. For technical merit, 5.4 to 5.7.
And a surprise, 5.4. Remember, the judges are looking for a well-balanced program with good choreography, spins, and jumps, and it just didn't happen for Elvis tonight.
And the second set for presentation, 5.3 up to 5.7 for the three-time world champion. And coming up next, the man who had an impressive quadruple jump in his short program, Cheng Cheng Li of China skates when we come back. Cheng Cheng Li, the 20-year-old who has been the surprise of the championship so far, part of an emerging Chinese skating system that is becoming increasingly competitive.
Tradition is a pillar of China's rich civilization. For Cheng Cheng Li, skating was the legacy, passed to him from his father, a member of the Chinese national hockey team in the 1960s, and his mother, a former world-class speed skater. His parents, now coaches, set him on his path to destiny when he was only 3 years old.
He was very small and short, but he was quick in learning and he was active too. At the beginning, the other coaches thought he was too young and too short to learn skating, but I thought it would be an opportunity for him, and he had the talent.
While his father once dreamed of raising a hockey player, he is now the proud parent of one of China's brightest young stars.
I think this is just the beginning for my son, because though he has participated in some Asian games, he has never participated in the World Championships. It is my dream that he will get at least third at Worlds. I tell him, he must be patient.
Since 1980, when post-revolutionary China resumed sending skaters to international competitions, patience has given way to a full-scale effort to win medals now. Chinese men's singles have been criticized for a woeful lack of artistic flair. And to remedy this, China has been borrowing increasingly from Western methods and styles.
Figure skating is upgrading day by day in China, and there are a lot of skaters who are all dreaming of performing better in international competition. There are certainly a lot of good skaters in the world, and we can learn from them to become better skaters.
At age 20, Li is the product of 20 years of effort to put Chinese skating on the map. Fluid in his choreography and deadly accurate with his quad, his first obstacle to making his mark on the international scene is his best friend, Cheng Jin Guo.
During competitions, we compete, but after, we are closest friends. We eat together, we train together, we live together, we're always together.
In Chinese skating, a seniority system exists. And for now, Guo, the older skater, is the number one male on the national team, the one sent to the 99 Worlds, even though Li won Chinese nationals. Guo is a strong technician, but he has yet to overwhelm an international audience. This year could be Li's chance.
I used to dream of being world champion. As I got older, I realized how hard it is. I still dream about it. It will take a lot of work, but I will try my best.
If he is going to beat out his good friend Guo to make that spot on the world team and make his first trip, this event might factor in a huge way. A win over guys like Stoiko and Yagudin would be very impressive. Cheng Jin Li of China.
Well, Terry, talk about someone who hit an exceptional quadruple toe loop in the short program. Let's see if he can repeat here in this free program. No. Another fall. Triple axel. That's the kind of landing he was looking for on the quad. There's no deduction for the fall on the quad in the pre-program, but your base mark just starts that much lower. Remember, 6.0 is a perfect mark in Olympic eligible skating. So you bring that base mark down when you fall. And he is not skating well with just a single axel there. Shocking.
As impressive as he was in the short program with the quad and the rest of the program, he is struggling now. Struggled in practice yesterday and really took a nasty fall into the boards and was injured for a while. Injured his left elbow.
Thing Chen Chang has going for him is he can really spring into the air, but you see that timing isn't there. If you don't have the timing going into these jumps, you don't get the height you need to rotate. It shows that his rhythm is off. Excellence in his jumping that we saw in the short program. Triple loop looking really cautious, but getting that one off right in front of the judges. Bear in mind, this man's debut in international figure skating was just last year when he was at the Junior World, so he's still collecting a lot of experience. This is a ton of pressure to compete against the likes of Stoiko, Eldridge, and certainly Yagudin.
Well, the pressure is certainly there, but you never get a better opportunity for Cheng Jing Li. With Stoiko already struggling, Yagudin and Eldred still to come, he could have taken command of this free skate and really didn't. Cheng Jing Li of China.
Kind of a similar fall compared to Stoiko. Just doesn't get the leg back and get the arms out to stop the rotation. So far, we've seen two quad attempts and two falls. Here is the triple axel. 3.5 times around. Nice there. Look at the quick rotation for the triple toe loop. Well done.
Some fine moments, but not the program Li was looking for. Now the judge's decision. For technical merit, 4.6 up to 5.4.
Well, your point was well taken. If you're going to skate against the big guns, You have got to deliver the jumps, and that did not happen tonight.
You can see the look on his face, too, and he knew he had a golden opportunity, and it didn't happen for him. The presentation 5.0 up to 5.4, so Zheng Zhenli of China in second place. When we come back, the two-time and reigning world champion from Russia, Alexei Yagudin, takes the ice. He feels the burden of trying to remain number one.
Actually, it's harder to stay on top than to be top 10, for example, to be ninth or eighth, because in all practices, in all events, you're supposed to be the best, and you're supposed to show for all people and for judges your best skating, and you can't do any mistakes. So it's hard to be on top.
Back in Canada, we are in St. John, New Brunswick, the wind constantly whipping off the Bay of Funday. Well, the ISU Grand Prix of Figure Skating rolls on December 5th with the Nations Cup competition. Maria Butyrskaya heads the list, the reigning world champion. The Nations Cup comes your way December 5th at 4 o'clock Eastern Time right here on ABC Sports. The men's free skate continues now with the skater who has been the best in the world the past 2 years. Had some bumps along the way away from the ice, but Alexei Yagudin has never looked more confident or relaxed than here at Skate Canada. The leader after the short program.
This is a very brilliant interpretation to the music from the soundtrack, The Broken Arrow. Notice the choreography and how he combines that with some of the most incredible jumps in the world of men's figure skating today. He's got 8 triples planned. And here is the first. This will be the triple axel, triple toe loop, the first. Just getting up in the air, perfect. Terry, we've seen failure with the quad so far. Will Yagudin be the first one to do it here? No, he goes down 2, that's 3.
So no one has been able to successfully do the quad. And remember, Todd Eldridge, still to come, does not have a quad plan. But obviously he is very, very consistent. The door may be open for the 96 world champ.
Can he get it back on this next triple axel? There you go, that was better. But still, flip, triple toe, really falling off. He almost went down on the second jump.
Alexei coming off a win at Skate America, but he did not earn Grand Prix points there. He designated that as a non-scoring event. This one does count in standings. Remember, you can skate in up to 3 events, but only 2 of those are designated as scoring competitions. All leading up to the Grand Prix final in Lyon, France, in January here on ABC.
Now, here's some of his unique choreography that he incorporates into this free program. Very easy triple loop. He's 3 minutes into the program. He's got about 1.5 minutes to go. Question is, will he get stronger or start to drop off?
Remember, the altitude in Colorado Springs at Skate America really bothered him, but we are at sea level here in St. John.
Oh, that is really bizarre. He got too far forward, and that's why he almost went over his toe pick. The teeth on the front of the blade.
He's laughing about it right now.
Hey, the ice is very slippery after all. Losing it. Looks like he's just falling off. Doesn't have the energy he needs. Oh boy, Todd Eldridge has got to be waiting in the wings thinking, I've got a chance.
Well, how different 4.5 minutes can be from the short program, where he was just unbelievable. So the struggles for Alexei Yagudin, this crowd sensing that the door may indeed be open for Elvis Stoiko. And remember, Todd Eldridge is still the skate. He's got a long way to come back, though. He's in fourth after the short program.
The quad, it seems to get up into the air nicely, good tight position, but again, short on the rotation. Did you see the blade, how it wasn't all the way around? That is four rotations complete. This is plain and simple. He just gets too far forward on his skates. And down he goes.
A very popular or unpopular decision about to be made by the judges with this crowd here in Canada. The decision now by the judges. Alexei Yagudin and Tatiana Tarasova watch for technical merit. 5.6 to 5.8, Peter.
Really? What an amazing situation here. Stoiko did four triples. Now Yagudin did 6-7 if you want to count the step out.
But how many stumbles did he have and falls in other areas of his program? Now the presentation marks 5.5 to 5.8, and they've put Yagudin in the lead over Elvis. Oh my.
Backstage, Michelle Kwan has just arrived at Harbor Station. She skates with the ladies in a bit. But up next, Todd Eldridge takes the ice right after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Our mobile update is a look back at the pairs competition earlier here at Skate Canada. Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Sikorodlidze provided the drama as they took the ice coming off a third-place finish at Skate America and a mistake-filled short program here. Amid reports there was a rift between the two-time and reigning world champions, they responded with their best performance of the season, winning the title, the 12 Grand Prix points for the win, pushing their total to 19 overall and vaulting them into the lead in the Grand Prix standings.
So it's Alexei Yagudin, a very unpopular decision so far. He is in the lead. Elvis Stoiko in second. Cheng Zheng Li of China in third. And here is the 96 world champion, American Todd Eldridge, taking the ice. In fourth place after the short program, trying to perhaps grab that second spot behind Yagudin.
And Todd Eldridge has been here before. He knows how to deal with pressure. He has no quadruple plan. However, if he can nail all of his triples, not even close to the first one, a single axel.
All the expectations for this free skate, and the skating has not met those.
Oh, loop. And turning out of the landing of that, you might be wondering, what is going on with the jumps?
Did we watch these same skaters in the short program? They were terrific. And now they're really struggling.
The focus, the concentration, and the timing has all got to be there. And that appears to be not the case with these men tonight.
Making his lone Grand Prix appearance. He will not try to earn a spot in the Grand Prix final in Lyon. Wants to remain eligible and competitive and perhaps stick around for the 2002 Olympic Games.
Not getting the spring he needs. You just want the program to stop. Todd Eldridge has always been a brilliant spinner. But you've got to balance it out with jumps. It didn't happen. And Terry, this is going to sound strange, but sometimes...
Well, he knows what kind of program it was, at least.
Yeah. Sometimes, if the energy isn't right in the building, in other words, Stoico didn't start the energy up high, so it sort of rippled through the whole men's event.
Gotta love his sense of humor, though, as he leaves the ice, gesturing to the crowd. Yeah, I know it wasn't really the Todd Eldridge you know.
Now, the triple does not occur because of the legs. Watch them split apart right there. It completely stops the rotation. And then he gets it back on the triple toe loop. Gets the rotation on this triple axel, however, pitches forward, hands go down, and he hits the ice.
Fierce competitors on the ice. Afterwards, you hang out together and watch a sporting event on TV. Your three leaders right there, Alexei Yagudin, Cheng Jing Li of China, and Elvis Stoico. And here is Todd Eldridge now, the first set of marks, 5.1 up to 5.3.
And you can just see the disappointment in his face with the failure on the jumps.
And now the second set, 5.3 up to 5.6. So Todd Eldridge in third place, right behind Elvis Stoico. Terry Gannon, Peter Carruthers with the men's free skate going on. It's Yagudin, Stoico, and then Eldridge, your top three, as Laurent Tobel takes the ice. And now the reigning champion of France. And always unique. And skating here to the music, the motion picture, Austin Powers. In garb.
You know, he was barrel rolling on that in practice, hitting the boards. What an accomplishment for him. 6'4", and does he get up into the air and watch him entertain.
Skater that comes to mind when you always hear laughter during his programs in the audience.
That's interesting. In his music, you've got a fire alarm going off.
That is not a part of the music, folks.
Oh, you fooled me. I thought with Tobel.
You never know.
Yeah, but you're right.
Well, no one's leaving the building. If you smell smoke, let me know.
Watch this. The second triple axel, he nails it. Tobel is having a personal best right now. Hang on. Fire alarm going off. Tobel, all the men fall apart. And look what he delivers. Look at this. He's doing these triples while this fire alarm is going off through his whole program. He's the most focused man in the competition tonight. Thank you. The fire alarm stops. He stops.
The bell is tolled. Lorenzo Bell. There it goes. During most of the program, the fire alarm goes off, and it just stopped at the end of this free skate.
You got to give this performance to Tobel.
And we'll return with the scores for Lorenzo Bell, and then Takeshi Honda of Japan takes the ice. Back in Canada, St. John, New Brunswick, with the chilly winds whipping off the Bay of Fun Day. Well, the ISU Grand Prix of Figure Skating rolls on December 5th, the third event in the series, the Nations Cup. And Maria Butyrskaya heads the list, the reigning world champion. That's December 5th, 4 o'clock Eastern, here on ABC Sports. And ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com, part of the Go Network. It is hard to steal the show in Canada from Elvis Stoico, but Lorenzo Bell may have just done it. First set of marks, 4.6 up to 5.4.
Well, considering what the other men put out there, you can't put him down with a 4.6. Another triple axel, and the triple toe loop right there. That is not worthy of a 4.6.
Peter, the second set for presentation, how do you give him a 4.9 on that presentation? Lorenzo Bell in fifth place overall behind Lee. So we're down to the final competitor here in the men's free skate. 18-year-old Takeshi Honda of Japan, twice the Japanese national champion. In his fifth in this event last season, and trying to do better than that. He is in fifth after the short program now. By the way, we have just been informed by an official from the International Skating Union that someone did indeed pull the fire alarm as a prank during Lorenzo Bell's program. So Bell, though, stayed focused and skated right through it.
Let's see if the curse of the jump stays with these men. No. Takeshi has a nice triple axel. Remember, we have not seen a quad. This is the last chance right here. Almost. But you can see how he stepped out. Incomplete.
So Stoico, Lee, Yaguchi, and Honda all trying quads. None of them successful.
That's what allowed him to land that jump nicely with good rotation.
Takeshi, a bit of a home favorite here. He now lives and trains in Ontario under the direction of Doug Lee, a longtime coach of Elvis Stoico until recently.
Thank you. He's got a lot of speed building up for this triple axel, and he'll go right for the triple toe. That helped him. That speed carried him through those two jumps. Do a triple axel, triple toe loop, and then fall on the triple loop. The concentration falls apart.
3 minutes and 25 seconds into your program, perhaps.
But true, but he's conditioned. He's not tired. But if you have one break in concentration, down you go. Going into this event, there was so much excitement. Three world champions, quads, and we really didn't see anything materialize.
Takeshi Honda of Japan, a few mistakes, but looks like he's happy with that effort here in the free skate, in fifth after the short program. To further your point, Alexei Yagudin, a controversial lead right now and winner of this event, and I'm sure he walks away saying, well, I won by default because it wasn't my best effort here.
Here's another look back at the triple axel. Up high in the air, and then bending down, reaching back for the next triple. Very straight, but not landed as clean as he'd like. But then on the triple loop, this. Look at him start to lean. Falls off the axis, the arms don't go out. No chance.
In what has been a mistake-filled free skate for the men, Takeshi Honda perhaps made less than a Todd Eldridge, for example. Here's the technical merit marks, 5.4 to 5.8, as Alexei Yagudin looks on with his coach, Tatiana Tarasova.
Some good scores in there, 5.8.
Presentation, 5.4 up to 5.9. So Honda able to move from fifth after the short up to third overall, edging out Todd Eldridge. But it's Alexei Yagudin who gets the win over Elvis Stoiko, who finishes second, then Takeshi Honda finishes third. Eldridge, Lee, and Tobel round out the top six. The Grand Prix standings look like this. Elvis in the lead after two events with 16 total points. Yagudin has 12, but remember, Skate America was a non-scoring competition for him. Then Timothy Gable with 9. Susie Wynn joins us right now backstage with our winner. Susie?
Thank you, Terry. Alexei, were you disappointed at all in your performance tonight and the results?
Yeah, actually, I was a little surprised when I became first anyway, so I was really ready for this competition, and I didn't feel any uncomfortable places in my free program, and I was really in shock when I fell a couple times in my free program, and I think we have 1 week to check our program again.
Did stamina or concentration factor in at any point?
I know, I felt really great before my skiing because warm-up was really good and it was so easy to skate there, and then something happened to me, I don't know what.
Back to you, Terry.
Peter, what about the top two men here? Who had the edge?
Well, nobody in the men's field did the quad, but let's compare Yagudin and Stoiko. Triples go to Yagudin, footwork. Yagudin gets the artistry and Stoiko gets the spins.
So the men's competition complete. It's time for the ladies to take the ice. And Michelle Kwan looks to move to 2-0 on the young season. She is the leader after the short program. The ladies' free skate is next when Skate Canada continues.
Thank you.